Hi, I'm Jackie Partridge. I'm an artist living and working in Wellesley, Ontario. And right now I'm going to be talking about some different art supplies that I recommend you using if you're starting out as a beginner with acrylic painting. So maybe you've never painted before, or maybe you've painted before and you're just looking to enhance and develop your skills. Then in this video, I'll be sharing some supplies I recommend to help you do the job and become a successful painter. So first of all, it's really important to cover the surface that you're working with. So this is just a tablecloth from Dollarama. It's a bit thicker, so the plastic is kind of strong. So this is kind of a good quality. I'll be able to wipe it off with a wet sponge and continue to reuse this tablecloth. So I really recommend getting some kind of tablecloth or making sure that you're working on an old surface, because acrylic paint does stain and it is very difficult to remove off of surfaces. Another thing I recommend is you wearing some kind of protection for your clothes. Again, acrylic paint won't wash off. It will stick to it. It kind of dries as this plasticky film. So this is a lab coat that I got from a thrift store. You could also use an apron. You could wear old clothes as well that you don't mind getting wrecked or ruined with paint. So that's very important. I also recommend using a canvas, of course. But it's really great to have an easel like this. So this is a tabletop easel that just sits on your table. It's adjustable, so you can adjust the height higher or lower based off of the size of canvas that you're working with. But it also folds and it becomes perfectly flat, which is really great for storing it. So you want to be using canvases to do your paintings on. Canvases come in all different shapes and sizes. This is 9 inches by 12 inches. When you're just starting out, it's a good idea to work with a smaller size because you'll be able to complete it faster and you won't be spending a lot of money on working on a larger canvas. The larger the canvas, the more expensive it's going to be. It's made with a wooden frame and the canvas is stapled over top of it. It has a grainy texture surface. And when you're painting, you want to make sure that you're painting the edges of your canvas as well and not the flat surface, because when it's hanging on a wall, you're going to be able to see the edges depending on where you're sitting or standing. So you can buy canvases in bulk. You can buy them in sets of 8 or 10, and that's going to be a cheaper price point kind of buying them in bulk. So that's something that I recommend for sure. I don't really recommend getting canvases at the dollar store. The quality just isn't the same, the surface quality. So I recommend going to a store like Curry's or Michael's. Again, you can check out my art supplies list as a PDF that will give you further details about different art supplies and where to purchase them from. Another option you can use is a canvas board. Canvas boards are really nice because they have the same texture as the canvas, so they have the same kind of grainy texture and they're nice and flat, so you can stack them up and they store really easy. They're also cheaper than a canvas because they don't have the wood on the back. It's kind of like this plasticky cardboard, so you're not paying for the wood that you are in the canvas, but the quality is still there. So it's really perfect for beginners who are just looking to practice and develop their skills. Another option, if either of these options are too expensive or out of your price range, or you're just really looking to paint a lot and practice a lot, you can use a thick watercolor paper. It will curl and buckle a little bit, but it's perfect for just starting out and kind of developing your skills. So the next thing that you'll need for your art supplies is some kind of rag. You can use paper towel. I don't like to use that just because you're going to be ending up going through a lot of paper towel, and you're using your rag for when you're dipping your brush in your water and changing the colors of your paint, just to help keep your brush clean as well as your paint clean. So this is a rag from an old pair of sweatpants. just the leg of the sweatpants. You could use an old t-shirt, an old cloth, anything like that that you can just use over and over again. And it's a little bit more environmentally friendly than buying a bunch of paper towel and using the paper towel. So the next thing you'll need is some kind of cup for your water. You could use an old jar as well that you're just going to keep the water for your brushes in. Then in terms of your brushes, you don't really need to start out with a lot of brushes. It can be really tempting to buy a bunch of brushes, or really overwhelming when you're looking at art supplies. Their brushes come in all different shapes and sizes. You can get short handles and you can get long handles as well. And it's really just based off of your preference. Do you like holding a short handle or do you like holding a long handle? So they both do the same thing, but it's really up to you. So I definitely recommend getting some flat brushes. So a flat brush has the flat edge across the top. This one is 2 inches wide, which is really perfect for painting a nice smooth and consistent background, like a sky, water, landscape, any kind of background. So this is really great to have. This is a flat brush as well. It's 1 inches wide, which again just helps you cover more ground and more space on your canvas, but it's a little bit smaller than the 2-inch brush, which is good for details and kind of filling in sections. And then you'll need at least one kind of detail brush. So this brush head is very, very small, less than a centimeter. And it's a round brush, which means the bristles come to a nice point. So this brush is really good for filling in details, like grass or painting hair, something like that, which is a really small area that you want to paint. So getting a couple sizes of a round brush, but definitely a really small one for details is needed. So if you have like 4 or 5 brushes, that's probably a good starting point to have. And next you want to have your palette. I really like this palette because it has a lid on top, so it actually stores the acrylic paint and prevents it from drying out. And when it dries out, it becomes like this plasticky film that you have to kind of throw in the garbage. So it has this lid that you can use as a palette as well. It also has different compartments to put different colors and mix different colors. So a lot of palettes kind of look like this, more traditional palettes, but they don't have a cover over top. So if you have something like this, you could try putting saran wrap or something over top, but it's not going to work as effectively as getting a palette with a nice lid like this. Alright, so that's the palette. I like a bigger palette too because it just gives you more room to mix paint. But again, it's totally your preference, and if you already have a palette at home, don't feel like you need to go out and buy your own. So the next thing that I want to talk about is paint. So paint can come in all different sizes of tubes. This is a larger jar, it's 500 milliliters, and this is a brand that I really recommend for students because it's a lower price point, but the quality is still good. So it is a thicker consistency, which is nice. Let me just open this. So it's not super liquidy. It still has a really nice consistency to it. And this brand is called Riotech. And there's other brands that I have linked in my art supplies PDF as well that you can take a look at. When you're buying paint, again, it can be very overwhelming. There's a lot of different colors. There's a lot of brands to choose from. But you want to make sure that you have your main colors, red, yellow, blue, which are your primary colors that help you mix other colors. So you can mix your own greens, you can mix your own browns and grays. You don't need to spend a lot of money buying these extra colors. You also want to get white and black. White is a color that people go through a lot because if their brush is dirty, then all of a sudden the white isn't white anymore. It's whatever color was on their brush. So I recommend buying white in bulk, at least 500 milliliters if possible, because that's a color that you're going to go through quicker and you're going to use a lot in your paintings. And you also want to make sure you're buying black. You won't need as much black, but black is good for creating those shades and those darker colors. And again, I'm going to show you how to mix your own colors, so you don't need to worry about that. I've written down on the art supplies list what types of blues or yellows or reds I recommend you buying, because there are different blues that come in different shades, and that's going to allow you to mix different colors of greens, purples, browns based off of the blue that you have. So it's good to buy two different blues if you can, but if you only have one shade of blue, this one's called cobalt, then that's fine too. It's just going to limit the amount of colors that you can end up mixing. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it was helpful to hear some of the supplies that I recommend. Make sure you check out the materials list of supplies as well, which will give you more details of where you can buy these supplies and what specific types you should buy. Of course, use your own supplies that you already have, but just take these recommendations to kind of help you if you're feeling stuck or unsure, because I know it can be overwhelming in an art supply store. Thanks for watching.